Okay, so I think we just got some chocolate milk in the mail. Got to open it up, but not expecting much else, and it certainly sounds like it. I believe it's going to be the Slate stuff, which is a recent product that's just come out. It was on, I think, Kickstarter. Was an initial supporter of that. It's a new brand of, I think, better for you kind of a thing, chocolate milk in a can. I believe there should be two flavors. And I'm pretty excited to try it. Really slick looking package with a kind of a matte finish can or wrap on the can. Both classic chocolate milk and dark chocolate milk. Pretty excited about these. They're lactose free. I think there's only 1 gram of fat per can in each of those and about 9 grams of sugar. So definitely more focused on the health side of things than the indulgence side necessarily, but they are going for a good tasting chocolate milk. And I would, you know, in looking at the stats of it, with only what, 120 calories per can, per 325 mils, you know, you learn to temper your taste expectations. But hey, for what it is, it can taste pretty decent. I am gonna pop these in the fridge. They say they're best refrigerated, so I'll put these in the fridge and probably crack these open tomorrow morning with a fresh mind and an untainted palate.
Okay, well, we won't be trying it up against the debackers. That wouldn't be a fair comparison. That stuff is global elite. So anyway, let's get started. All right, so before we dive into this, just a little bit of background on Slate. It was something that maybe about a year ago came out on Kickstarter. Two guys, I think from the Boston area, Manny and Josh, they wanted to make like a better for you kind of chocolate milk with lower fat, lower sugar, lactose free, gluten free, carrageenan free, higher protein, kind of ultra filtered and still UHT and can portable chocolate milk. Definitely supported that. They actually got a lot of support on Kickstarter, which was great. Over 50K and well over 1,000 supporters. So it's finally come out. They've shipped it and just arrived. So really excited to try it. Again, my expectations for taste, I rated on just on flavor and drinking experience in general. Tempered my expectations only because of the stats. You know, you hate to be tainted by that. Is this going to be the best tasting chocolate milk in the world? Probably not. But for the tranche that it's in, I suppose, we'll see how it compares to those. Maybe see how it compares to this Organic Valley Fuel 50% less sugar. This is definitely more the market that I think it's going for. So, and this stuff didn't taste very good. Newsflash. I know canned chocolate milk might be a novelty to some folks. It's pretty rare, although I've had quite a few relatively over the years, much more in Europe, with Ice Choco in Germany and the Netherlands. Costio Energy, I think, came in a can. Mad Croc, what else? I don't think Yoo-Hoo counts. Milo, Nestle Milo comes in a can sometimes. That stuff's unfortunate. Even that Monster energy drink stuff was horrendous. Any other canned stuff? There might have been a few others kicking around that I forgot about. I'd say the best tasting stuff I've had in the can is definitely the Mad Croc stuff that I had in Finland. It's a product in Germany. That stuff was actually pretty tasty. So in cracking these open and pouring them out, you'll notice quite a color differential. And they both actually look pretty nice. There is a little bit of a lingering whitish foam on the dark chocolate one, but all in all looks pretty good. You'd be able to tell them apart if you saw them outside the can. So let's try the milk chocolate one first. Okay, see what they're going for here. It's thin, which is okay. It's definitely not very milky, and there's both a kind of a powdery, chalky residue that you get very shortly after the sip. And the flavor is powerful. I don't want to say it's heavy-handed on the sweetness level, but there's a non-chocolate agent that kind of overpowers the experience. Yeah, I mean, it might be the monk juice extract that's in here to sweeten stuff. I've had some other products that have had that in there before, and it's tough to get the proportions right, since it's so much sweeter than sugar. This has that lingering sort of aftertaste in the mouth of definitely not chocolate, but it's definitely like kind of a, it tastes like an artificial type sweetener. I know monk fruit is not artificial, it's a fruit, it's a plant. But I think most people expecting chocolate milk might taste this and think, whoa, you know, that was a little bit off. So does the dark chocolate version fare any better? I would say slightly better, in my opinion, than the milk chocolate version, or maybe I'm just getting used to it. I just get a slightly less bite from, I think it's the sweetener that's in there, the overall experience. Is it more chocolatey? I don't know. Maybe I'm being conditioned by the color of it to expect it to be more chocolatey, but I'll try these more side by side and definitely provide that in the written review. Does this compare favorably to the Organic Valley Fuel stuff that is 50% less sugar? I'm gonna say it does not compare favorably. Now, this stuff was very unsweet, which I don't mind, but it did feel somewhat milky. There was some tie back to this coming out of a cow at some point. And it, even though it uses stevia instead of monk juice extract, which oftentimes can be more egregious, but I think in that case, I give the drinking experience, both flavor and texture, the edge to the Organic Valley stuff. Well, I hate to give anything a bad review, but I feel like if I said the stuff tasted great, it would call my integrity into question when comparing to regular chocolate milks, which arguably is not the market they're going for. This is more for the better for you kind of a market for sure. And if you're looking for something like that, I recommend looking at Slate milk. If taste and flavor isn't your first priority, which I completely understand if it isn't, I was at slatemilk.com, and you can order this stuff and they'll send it to your house. If you're in the market for this type of a product, give it a shot. Even another flavor, espresso coffee, which has real coffee in it, and has quite a kick to it. I had some last night and it works. So anyway, hey, thumbs up for the effort, guys. I wish I could give it a better review flavor-wise, but for me, drinking this for enjoyment is not something that I would do. I'm actually gonna go run back to my debackers in the fridge and polish that off. And I hate to do a negative review. I only review in terms of taste. So, and this stuff to me does not compare favorably with your average chocolate milk. Hopefully they'll continue to innovate, maybe tweak the formula and, you know, make it taste a little bit better down the road. But for the time being, I'd not recommend it for recreational purposes. It reminds me of a little bit of what paint thinner smells like. It has a little bit of that sort of flavor. Paint thinner smells sort of pleasant to me in short doses, I think. I don't know. That's probably an indictment right there. Thank you.